Before we get into building apps with Fiori Elements, we would like to take a few minutes to introduce you to OData, the protocol of choice for SAP Fiori. First, I'm going to explain you what OData is and show you what it looks like, and then my colleague Stefan will show you how you can enrich the data with semantic information using annotations. OData is an OASIS standard that defines best practices for building and consuming RESTful APIs. It's used in SAP to define the business data models for SAP Fiori, for example, S4, SAP Business Warehouse, as well as SAP Cloud Platform. With OData, you can easily query and manipulate data in a generic way. Let me show you that using the OData reference service Trippin. This service document describes all the collections that are available from this service. For example, we see people, airlines, airports, and so on. Let's have a look into the people collection. If we request this entity without any parameters, it will respond with the complete list of all people with all the defined properties. We can restrict the properties to those we are interested in by using the $select clause. In this case, it's username, first name, and last name. To refine the result list, the $filter clause can be used. In this case, we are only requesting people whose username starts with R. But there might be also use cases where we want to select a specific instance by providing a key property. In this case, it would be username. Let's take Russell White. By using now the $expand clause, we are able to add data from associated entities to the selected instances. In this case, we see all trips Russell White has done. I will stop here, but the takeaway of this example is to illustrate how easy it is to retrieve dedicated data from an OData service. In addition, OData also offers a machine-readable description of the corresponding data model, the metadata. Let's take a look. Looking at the metadata, we can see the entity set people that we drilled down into earlier. It refers to the entity type person that has properties like username, first name, and last name. And there's also a navigation to the entity type trips. The availability and existence of this metadata enables now the creation of powerful generic client tools and frameworks. Let me show you a few. These tools were created by the OASIS OData Technical Committee to produce an open API description out of OData services in a generic way. The Microsoft Graph API provides access to a huge amount of data in Office 365 using OData. You can explore it yourself using the Microsoft Graph Explorer and your Office 365 account. And last but not least, SAP has implemented the UI5 OData model that gives UI5 developers an easy and generic access to all OData services. Now that you have sensed what OData looks like, I will hand it off to Stefan, who is going to talk a little bit about semantics.
We add semantic information to OData using annotations. This enables SAP Fiori Elements to display the desired screen elements as part of the user interface. Additionally, annotations can provide information about the capabilities of the OData service. For example, if a user can create a new object. Let's take a look at a couple of practical examples of an SAP Fiori app. Here you can see the semantic relationship between two properties of the product entity. The term isocurrency is being taken from the measures vocabulary to indicate that the property currency is displaying the relevant currency for the price property. This allows the rendering of the currency next to the price, as well as the correct formatting of the price. As a second example, we can annotate the property product picture URL with the term isImageURL. This does what you would expect it to do, allow a UI to display a picture. As a third example, I can create a ratings chart by providing a key figure with a target value, which is 5 here, and a current value, which comes from the property average rating. It will also add the semantic information that explains that this figure represents a rating. Put together, this will allow us to display a familiar looking chart with stars that is typically used to visualize how products are perceived. As an important side note, the vocabulary terms used in this video are taken from vocabularies established by OASIS and SAP, both available on GitHub and the SAP Community Wiki. Coming back to annotations, you can also use them to group properties. As a quick example, you can create a table displaying all the properties that I showed you earlier using a term from the UI vocabulary line item. Combining those properties with the UI line item annotation will create a list like you see here. To summarize, we use OData metadata and annotations to provide a timeless description of the data in your app, as well as hints on how that data should be used, its behavior, possible actions, and so on. The format of OData is independent of the backend implementation, client programming language, and the design of the UI. We will get into how you use OData and annotations to actually build an SAP Fiori Elements app in the next few videos. Stay tuned!